I was wondering, because the film, the protagonists are surrounded by music pretty much the whole time that we're with them.
Right.
How did you manage to get the type of access that would be required to make this film in such tender and sort of ways that are very clearly full of trust? How did that happen?
Sure. So, you know, I think a byproduct of there being so much media surrounding this, who were putting out daily news, was that they were looking for someone to talk to who wasn't going to just shove a microphone in their face and try to get them to say the most crazy thing possible, because that's what they were seeing on the daily news. They were watching themselves on TV every night, and they saw when people would, you know, pick and choose and cherry pick what they were saying, and they really wanted to get their message out there. They wanted to be listened to. That's why they did this entire thing, is they wanted to be listened to. And while I didn't agree with everything they were saying, like, I was that trusted voice trying to find common ground with them at the very least, and not putting out things there every night, and then actually setting down the camera for hours at a time, and not you know, trying to get that one soundbite to put out on the evening news and whatnot. So I think that to them that was very valuable, that I was actually genuinely listening and trying to capture the human story of this accusation.
Have they seen it yet?
They have not seen it. A lot of them are in jail, so they can't. But some of them are not, and they haven't seen it yet. So
do you feel that if they watch this film, they'll feel that trust was sort of fulfilled? Do you think that this tells the story that they wanted to tell?
I don't know if it's the story that they want to tell, but I think they would acknowledge that I gave them a fair shake, because that's something that I really wanted to do with this film. I don't agree with their politics in a lot of ways. In some ways, like the militarization of the police, I do. But I wanted to give them a fair hearing that they weren't getting from the everyday media. But I also didn't want to make a propaganda piece like supporting this occupation as well. So I think some of them would recognize that. Some of them obviously will never see something that they like that's about them. So.
Great. Some questions? Yes.
Hi.
So the questions are,
are
you planning on showing this to the members of the film, and also, were you in the car, or how did you get that footage?
Sure, so I am planning on showing it to them. We are looking for a home for this film right now in terms of distribution. I'd like for it to get out there in as many eyes as possible, because this is a very human story, and I want people to see this and see the humanity in this, even if they disagree with them on a fundamental level. And there are certain people that I am going to reach out to and show on an individual basis, because I really want to talk to them, and because this is a hugely emotional thing for them. This is something that's profoundly affected their lives in like an existential way. Like, one man's dead, a lot of people are going to jail for a long time. So I am going to reach out to them and try to show them. The second question, was I in the car? I was not. I was almost in the car. One of the days we were shooting, and they were planning on going to this meeting in Jande, I had actually, you know, I'd been trying to get, you know, in with these guys and like film as much as possible with them, because I didn't know when this thing was going to end. So I had asked if I could ride with them to the meeting in Jande, and they initially said yes, but then it's actually kind of mundane why I didn't end up riding with them, is one of the young women who was out at the refuge needed a ride, and I had a car, so they're like, "Do you mind driving?" And I was like, "Of course not." You know, I was trying to be a nice guy and whatnot. So she ended up riding with them, and I ended up driving ahead of them. And I was actually at the meeting in John Day that they were trying to go to. And the footage itself actually came from two sources. The aerial shot that you see was released by the FBI shortly after the shooting of LaVoy Finicum. They were trying to get out in front of any kind of conspiracy theories that LaVoy had been assassinated or whatnot, with, you know, varying success on that end, and that there were actually two cell phone video shots from inside the car, which we combined the two, the audio and the video of the two, that was released by the Oregon State Police weeks later.
You did a really good job
with that.
You did a great job.
Oh, thank you so much.
She really liked it.
Yeah. I like that.
Another question?
Well, I have two.
two questions. The first is, was there ever a moment when you were experienced and had to justify yourself as being a member of the liberal media elite? You know, there obviously was some interface where they melted a little and you melted a little so that there could be the interaction. And can you tell us about any of the people that you kept in touch with? Do they regret it?
So I'll just repeat so the people in the back can hear. The first question is, did you have to identify yourself with the liberal media or any sort of affiliation with the media in order to communicate? And the second was...
were you experienced that way? Because there is very much disdain and dislike what they experience with the liberal media.
Or rather, what is that...
Was that a hindrance?
Yeah.
And sure, yeah, you know, they were very distrustful of anyone with a camera, and rightfully so. There were people that were just out for the gotcha moments with cameras, and they were getting the gotcha moments, and they were putting them out there, and they were really ridiculing these people. I think what worked to my advantage was that I would talk to them, and I made no secret of my political affiliation, but at the same time, I never wanted to lie to them, and that was something that was very important to me. But at the same time, there were these islands of common ground that we could find. And I truly believe that if you're a human being on this planet, if you drill down deep enough, we all have the same values. And so that's kind of where I tried to get to and steer these conversations to. And again, putting down the camera and talking to them on a one-to-one basis or in a group basis or whatever, you know, standing around the campfire with them, I think was tremendously valuable in terms of getting the access that I did. And I am from Georgia. I grew up in Georgia, and so I had some sort of like redneck cachet, you know, some weird street cred. But as David Holbrook calls me, I am the redneck hipster. So, what was the second part of the question?
The second part was,
Do they regret it?
Yeah.
Yeah, and sure, they do. Some of them do, some of them don't. Like Jason Patrick is very much standing on his principles, and he does not regret it. He is the one who is actually going to fall on that axe, or the axe is going to fall on him harder than anyone else. Some of them have pled guilty. Some of them are seeking out lesser charges and whatnot, and I think some of those folks do regret it. You know, and what I like to emphasize when I'm talking about this film is that this movement, this occupation, wasn't monolithic. There were a lot of people with varying motivations and whatnot that were there because they had this very vague but profound sense that something was wrong with America, and I think that's something we can all identify with, especially right now. And so I can't speak for every single one of them, and so I would say some do regret it and some do not.
But ultimately advanced the movement. But ultimately, it advanced the movement for them. So that's profound.
Yeah, absolutely. The Voice that has kind of solidified their commitment to this cause, especially in terms of people who weren't directly involved. Like, it has provided a martyr for them to coalesce around.
So unfortunately, we don't have time for any other questions. But I want to remind you all to vote. For the audience award, if you loved this film.